2012 has already seen its fair share of severe weather, and meteorologists say the true season for tornadic storms is just now getting underway. Experts at the University of Alabama at Birmingham say it's critical to have a plan in place to stay safe.
Just because you feel that you've lived through the tornadoes, they didn't affect you, it's not something that bothers you, that's not reason alone to not be prepared.
UAB's Josh Klapo is a clinical psychologist and certified disaster mental health specialist. He says if you're anxious about the upcoming season, putting together a severe weather safety plan can help you channel those feelings into something both productive and protective.
You have to know where your safe place is to go.
Sarah Nafziger is in the UAB Department of Emergency Medicine. She says once you've identified your safe place, like the center of your home or a local storm shelter, be sure you have a way to find out about severe weather.
If you're unaware, then you can't get to your safe place. So if that's using a weather radio or an application on your phone or using a social networking tool, whatever you have available that can alert you that the storm is coming, you need to use that so that you know and you know to get in that safe place.
Nafziger says you cannot rely on outdoor warning sirens, so you definitely need that weather alert device. You'll also need non-perishable foods, bottled water, required medications, a flashlight, masks, work gloves, and plastic tote bins to store these items in. If severe weather is coming, keep a charge on your cell phone, wear proper shoes, and grab your wallet. And most importantly, have helmets available for all family members.
My first order of business is to protect the person. And then all the things in the preparedness kit can be put to good use by the person who didn't get a headache.
Dr. Russ Fine is the director of the UAB Injury Control Research Center. He says after the historic tornado outbreak in April of 2011, his team searched for the best way to prevent head injuries in storms, and helmets are the recommendation.
People go airborne, there are things flying around that strike the head, and all you have to do is have something between the skull and whatever is flying around or whatever the head might strike that will absorb that energy, and that can make the difference between life and death.